Good morning, dear students. I hope you are all safe by staying at home. This is 10th standard. The topic is carbon and its compounds. We know that carbon is inseparable element in human life since it forms more number of products. It forms more number of compounds. For example, the food that we eat, the dress materials that we wear, cosmetics, paints, oils, so many things, etc. in our life are made up of carbon. So carbon makes our life easy and comfort. So without carbon, the existence of life in earth, life on earth is impossible. It forms more than 5 million products. Carbon forms more than 5 million products. That is much higher than that of any other element in the periodic table. What makes the carbon to combine with other elements to form so many compounds? Three properties, mainly three properties made carbon to combine with some other elements to form a innumerable number of products. What are the three properties? Catenation, tetravalency in nature, and multiple bonding. These three characters, these three properties makes carbon to form innumerable compounds. And the bond exists between the carbon compound is covalent nature, so the carbon compounds are called organic compounds. Now we are going to see the characteristics of organic compound. First property, it has organic compounds has higher molecular mass. It has higher molecular mass and the structure is complex structure. It is not a simple structure, it is complex structure. So they have higher molecular mass and the structure is complex. And second one, solubility. It is insoluble in water but soluble in some of the solvents like carbon tetrachloride, toluene and ether, etc. So it is insoluble in water. Carbon compounds are insoluble in water, but it is soluble in carbon tetrachloride, toluene, ether, etc. And then it is highly inflammable. That means it will catch fire easily. It catch fire easily and it burns in oxygen. So it is highly inflammable. And the reactivity of carbon compounds are less when compared to the inorganic compounds. The reactivity of carbon compounds, organic compounds are less when compared to inorganic compounds. And then the bond nature is covalent bond. The bond exists between the carbon compounds. Covalent nature. The melting point and high boiling points are very low when compared to inorganic compounds. The melting point and boiling point of organic compounds are less when compared to inorganic compounds, and it exhibits the property isomerism. That means a single structural formula represents several organic compounds in which they have different physical and chemical property. Same structure but different properties, that is called isomerism, that is exhibited by organic compounds. And then it is volatile in nature. Volatile means easily vaporizable, that is called volatile. Volatility means easily vaporized, that is, so they are volatile in nature and they are prepared in the laboratory. Organic compounds can be prepared in the laboratory, that's why we are getting plastics, terylene, etc. And next, why we need classification? Carbon, the bond exists between the carbon compounds are covalent in nature, already I said. Because of covalent in nature, it combines with other elements like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, etc. Because of that, we are getting so many products. And then the compounds having the same structural features may have different properties. So based on that, we are going to classify, based on the structure, we are going to classify the organic compounds into two broad classification. One is acyclic or open chain. Second one is cyclic or closed chain. First one, acyclic or open chain. The carbon, the bond exists between carbon and carbon is covalent in nature. Covalent means sharing. This also will be contributing equal number of electron, and this atom also will be contributing equal number of electron. So the contributed electrons are shared between two atoms. That kind. So because of that, the bond is formed. That means this will be contributing a certain number of electron, and this also will be contributing the same number of electrons. So the electrons are shared between the two atoms. So the bond existing between them is called covalent in nature. Carbon compounds, the bond exists between carbon compounds are covalent in nature. So this is, and carbon has the unique ability to link with other carbon atom to make it as a long chain. That property is called catenation. So carbon chemistry is the chemistry of catenated carbon compounds, and because of its covalent nature, we have two kinds of classification of carbon compounds: acyclic or open chain. That is first one, cyclic or closed chain. First we are going to see acyclic or open chain. The bond formed between carbon and compound makes it as a linear chain. Linear chain means like a line. So the carbon linked with other carbon in a linear chain, in a linear pattern to make it as a chain. That is called acyclic or open chain. It contains three kinds of bond. One is single bond, second one is a double bond, and third one is a triple bond. The single compound is, if the bond exists between the carbon atom, a single bond means that is saturated. So the bond exists between the carbon. The bond exists between the carbon and carbon is single bond, means that kind of compounds are called saturated acyclic compounds, because this is make it as a chain, linear pattern to make it as a chain. So acyclic. So the bond exists between the carbon and carbon is single bond, means that is saturated acyclic chain. And then the bond exists between carbon and carbon is double bond or triple bond, means that is called unsaturated. So we have two classification in acyclic. One is saturated and another one is unsaturated. Saturated means the bond exists between carbon and carbon is a single bond, that is saturated. If the bond exists between carbon and carbon is double or triple, means that is unsaturated acyclic compound. And then next one, cyclic or closed chain. The bond exists between the carbon and carbon to make it as a cyclic or closed, means that is a cyclic or closed chain. In that, if the closed chain is made up of a similar kind of atoms. So for example, here also carbon, here also carbon, here also carbon, here also carbon. So the bond exists, the cycle is made up of a same kind of atom. This cycle is made up of a same kind of atom. Carbon, 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 carbon. This is called a carbocyclic, because this is purely made up of a carbon. The cycle is purely made up of carbon, so these kind of compounds are called carbocyclic. And what is heterocyclic means? Carbon linked with some other atoms. Here it is carbon. Carbon is linked with some other atoms. So if the carbon is linked with some other atom, means that is called heterocyclic compounds. So the cyclic or closed chain compounds are further classified into two types: carbocyclic, heterocyclic. Carbocyclic means the chain is made up of a same kind of atom, that is purely made up of carbon, then it is called carbocyclic. And what is heterocyclic means, if the carbon makes the closed chain with some other atoms, then it is called a heterocyclic. Example, furan. This is a furan. This is a cyclobutane, because four carbon atoms are there, therefore that is a butane. That is formed in cycle, so it is called a cyclobutane. And then ring structure, so it is cyclobutane. And then further, the carbocyclic compounds are further classified into two types: alicyclic and aromatic. Alicyclic means aromatic, means that is the carbon compounds which contains aroma, that means smell. That kind of compounds are called aromatic. The basic structure of aromatic contains a benzene ring. The benzene ring contains alternative double bond. Alicyclic means it may be closed chain, made up of a single bond or double bond. It may be saturated. Alicyclic may be saturated or unsaturated. But aromatic compounds are unsaturated because that contains alternate double bonds. So this is about the classification based on structure. Next we are going to see based on kind of atoms. Already I said that carbon has the unique ability to link with other atoms like hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen, etc. to form innumerable number of compounds. So because of that we need classification, how it is combining with other elements to make it as a compound. Based on that we can classify into functional group and hydrocarbon. Functional group and hydrocarbon. First we are going to see hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means the carbon compounds that contains only carbon and hydrogen. The organic compounds which is made up of carbon and hydrogen, that is called hydrocarbons. The hydrocarbons are further classified into three types: alkane, alkene and alkyde. Alkane means the carbon-carbon. If there is a carbon-carbon single bond, if there is a bond between the compound is carbon-carbon single bond, means that is alkane. The general formula of alkane is CnH2n+2. N may be 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And this is saturated because carbon-carbon single bond is there. So this is a saturated hydrocarbon. The first member in this series, the first member is methane and the second member is ethane. If the number of carbon atom is 1, if the n value is 1, means then hydrogen 2 × 1 + 2, therefore 2 × 1 = 2, 2 + 2 = 4, therefore CH4. The first member is methane and the second member is ethane, like that. And then the second classification in hydrocarbon is alkene. The general formula of alkene is CnH2n. The bond exists between carbon and carbon is a double bond. So the simplest, this is unsaturated because double bond exists between the carbon and carbon. So this is a unsaturated hydrocarbon, and the simplest hydrocarbon contains two carbon atoms. The simplest hydrocarbon contains two carbon atoms, N2, therefore C2, 2 × 2 = 4, therefore hydrogen 4. The structure is a CH2, double bond CH2. This is the first member of the alkene family. This is the simplest hydrocarbon of alkene family. And then alkyne, if the compound contains carbon-carbon triple bond, if the compound contains a carbon-carbon triple bond, then it is called an alkyne. The general formula of alkyne is CnH2n−2. In this also, this is also unsaturated because triple bond is there, so this is unsaturated. And then the first member, the simplest hydrocarbon contains two carbon atoms, therefore C2, 2 × 2 = 4, 4 − 2 = 2, therefore C2H2. Therefore the first member is acetylene, CH, triple bond, CH. Some of the examples for alkane, alkene and alkyne is given in our book. For example, number of carbon atom is 1 means the alkane formed here is a methane. But there is no alkene and alkyne with 1 carbon atom because the simplest alkene and alkyne starts with 2 carbon atoms. And then the number of carbon atoms 2 means the alkane is ethane. This is methane, this is ethane, this is propane, this is butane, this is pentane. The succeeding members or the preceding one, the difference is CH2. For example, when we add CH4 with the CH2, we will be obtaining the next member of the alkane family. this is methane. When we add CH2 with the CH4 with the CH2, we will be getting the next member of the alkane family, that is ethane. When we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member, that is C3H8, that is a propane. When we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member, that is a propane, and the last one is a butane. And alkane, already I told that it starts with two carbon atoms. The simplest alkane contains two carbon atoms. Therefore, with two carbon atoms, this is C2H4. This is called ethene. The ene should be replaced with ene. Therefore, this is ethene. And the alkyne family that contains two carbon atoms, so this is ethine. Ethene, ethine. Ethane, ethene, ethine. And this is propane. This is propene. This is propyne. And then this is butane, and this is butene, this is butane, this is pentane, pentene, pentine. And next we are going to see the characteristics of hydrocarbons. What are the characteristics of hydrocarbons? The lower members of the hydrocarbon are gases. For example, methane, ethane are gases. So the lowest hydrocarbon, the lower members of the hydrocarbon are gases at room temperature. And then they are colorless and odorless. They don't have specific color and they don't have specific odor. So the LPG gas filled in a cylinder, in domestic cylinder, is made up of a hydrocarbon that does not contain any specific smell. So a smell is added to find out any leakage. That is the leak when the gas coming out from the cylinder is identified because of the smelling agent is added with that. Actually, the hydrocarbon is colorless and odorless. And then the boiling point of hydrocarbon increases with the increase in number of carbon atoms. For example, the methane, boiling point of methane is less. When we are going higher and higher members of this family, the boiling point increases because of the increase of a number of carbon atoms. So this will be getting more boiling point when compared to CH4. So boiling point increases with increase in number of carbon atoms, and it undergoes combustion reaction with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. Hydrocarbons undergoes combustion reaction. Combustion means burning with oxygen. So hydrocarbons undergoes combustion reaction with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water. And alkane is less reactive. Why alkane is less reactive means that is saturated. That contains only single bond, carbon-carbon single bond. So it is saturated. So it is less reactive. And alkane is more reactive. Why alkane is more reactive means that contains the carbon, the compounds contains carbon-carbon triple bond that is unsaturated. So that is more reactive. And this is insoluble in water. Hydrocarbons are insoluble in water. These are the characteristics of a hydrocarbon. Next, we are going to see the test for saturation. How to test whether the given compound is saturated? That means carbon-carbon single bond or carbon-carbon double bond. How to find out? By using the bromine water, we can find out whether the given compound contains carbon-carbon single bond or carbon-carbon multiple bonds. How to find out? Take two test tube. One test tube we are going to take acetylene, and another test tube we are going to take ethane. Ethane contains carbon-carbon single bond, whereas acetylene contains carbon-carbon triple bond. This is unsaturated, this is saturated. So we are going to take two test tube. One is one test tube, it is taken ethane, and another test tube acetylene is taken. When we are adding bromine water in both the test tube, the bromine water in acetylene decolorizes. It will decolorizes. The acetylene decolorizes the bromine water. The color will be changed. But ethane will not make any color change in bromine. So the color of the bromine will remain as such. So from that, we infer that the saturated compounds will not decolorize the bromine water, whereas unsaturated compounds decolorizes the bromine water. With bromine water, we can test whether the given compound is saturated or unsaturated. Next, we are going to see the classification based on functional group. Already I told that hydrocarbon contains hydrogen and carbon. That is the skeletal framework for other organic compounds, because replacing one or two hydrogen atoms from the hydrocarbon with other atoms or group of atoms, we are going to make this as a highly reactive. This is less reactive. By replacing one or two hydrogen atom from the hydrocarbon, we will make this as more reactive. So the reactivity increases by displacing one or two hydrogen atom with one atom or a group of atom. So replacing the hydrogen atom with an atom or group of atom changes the chemical property also. Before that, it will be getting some chemical property. After replacing the hydrogen atom with some other atoms, the chemical property will also changed. So what is functional group means? Functional group is nothing but an atom or group of atom that determines the chemical property of the compound. That is called a functional group. And carbon-carbon double bond is also considered as a functional group, and a carbon-carbon triple bond also considered as a functional group, because that is more, these two are more reactive than single bond. So these two also, double bond and alkene also considered as a functional group. Other than this, other than bond, we have some other functional group also. Alcohol, this is the functional group of alcohol, this is the functional group of acid, aldehyde, and then ether. Example, this is the molecular formula of ethane, C2H6. When we replace one of the hydrogen atom, H6 is there, we are going to remove one hydrogen atom. Instead of one hydrogen atom, I am going to add OH. So the chemical formula, now we obtained by replacing the hydrogen atom with OH is C2H5OH. This is alcohol. This is hydrocarbon, this is alcohol. So the general formula of alcohol is OH. OH is the functional group. The rest will consider as a alkane. Therefore, R. So this is the general formula of alcohol. And then the functional group, general formula, example. Functional group, OH is there, means that is alcohol. The functional group OH is attached with alkane. Hydrocarbon means that is alcohol. Therefore, the general formula ROH, R, instead of R, I'm going to substitute ethyl. Therefore, C2H5OH, this is ethyl alcohol. This is alcohol, this is ethyl, therefore ethyl alcohol. And then C double bond OH, that is aldehyde. This is the functional group of aldehyde. The general formula of aldehyde is RCHO. This is acetaldehyde. And then C double bond O. This is the functional group of ketone. And the general formula RCOR. We are going to substitute alkyl group in both sides. Therefore, this is methyl and this is methyl. So, dimethyl ketone. This is ketone. Functional group of ketone. Therefore, this side one methyl and this side one methyl. So, we have two methyl, dimethyl ketone. And then, this is the functional group of acid. The general formula RCOOH. Instead of R, we are going to substitute one alkyl family. Therefore, CH3COOH. This is acetic acid. And then, O is the functional group of ether, ROR. This is dimethyl ether, dimethyl ether. And then COR, this is the functional group of ester. The general formula RCOR, this is methyl acetate. This is acetate, this is methyl, therefore methyl acetate. Time irukan sir? Homologous series is a class or a group of organic compounds having the general molecular formula. They have the general molecular formula and similar chemical properties in which the successive members, in which the successive members differ by CH2 group. That means methylene group. CH2 is methylene group. So what is homologous series? Homologous series is a class or a group of organic compounds having general molecular formula. General molecular formula with the similar chemical properties. They have the similar, all the members have the same chemical properties in which the successive members differ by CH2 group. For example, alkane. This is one of the series. Homologous series. Alkane is one of the homologous series. The general formula of alkane is CnH2n+2. The first member, C, if n value is 1 means C1, therefore 2 into 1 2 2 plus 2 4 CH4. This is the first member of the alkane family. First member of the alkane family, the name of the first member of the alkane family is methane. And when we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member. So the succeeding member differ by a CH2. For this, when we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member. The name of the next member is ethane. When we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member, that is a propane, butane, pentane, like that. And then, what are the characteristics of homologous series? Each member in a series differs from the succeeding. Succeeding means, for example, this is the succeeding of this one. This is the preceding one of this one. When we subtract the CH2 from this, we will be obtaining this. When we add CH2 with this, we will be obtaining the next member. So each member in a series differs from the succeeding one or the preceding one by a group CH2 or by molecular mass of 14 AMU, that means atomic mass unit, 14 atomic mass unit. C12, hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 1 hydrogen, 1 mass of 1 hydrogen is 1, 2 hydrogen is there, therefore 2. So 12 plus 2, 14. So by the difference in molecular mass, 14 atomic mass unit. And then all the members contains the same element. For example, alkane means you cannot find out any other element except hydrogen and carbon. Only all the members hydrogen contains carbon and hydrogen, no other element is present. So all the members in a series contains same element and the same functional group. And then they are represented by general molecular formula. For example, alkane is represented by the general formula CnH2n+2, and alkane is CnH2n, and alkane is CnH2n-2. So all the members are represented by the general molecular formula, and the members in a series shows regular gradation in physical property. That means a little variation in physical property. For example, the boiling point of methane is, for example, 20 degrees Celsius means the next one 22, next one 24, like that. Regular gradation in their physical property. So there is a regular gradation in their physical property due to increase in molecular mass. And then they have the similar chemical properties. Similar chemical properties of the homologous series are the same. And then all the members can be prepared by general common method. So they can be prepared by common method. So this class, I'm going to wind up with this topic. Be safe, stay home.